Now we'll see what is state reduction. Okay. Now first of all we should know what is equivalent circuit. What is equivalent circuit? What is equivalent circuit? Now if identical input sequences are applied to the two circuits and identical outputs occur for all input sequences, then the two circuits are said to be equivalent and one may be replaced by the other. So what is the equivalent circuits? Suppose two circuits are there, circuit 1 and circuit 2. If you apply same set of input and if you get same set of outputs, then we can say C1 and C2, they are equivalent to each other. So first of all, to do this we have to identify the state table. Now we have to follow a rule to identify to reduce the state. Okay, so the rule is two states are said to be equivalent if for each member of the set of inputs they give exactly the same output and send the circuit either to the same state or to an equivalent state. Okay, we'll see the meaning of the definition. And when two states are equivalent, one of them can be removed without altering the input output relationships. So first of all we have to identify the equivalent states, and we can remove the one of the states, and if you remove the one of the state, that means we can reduce the number of states. And from the state table we look for the two present states that go to the same next state and have the same output for both the input. Okay, so one state diagram is there where the states are S1, S2, S3, S4, S5, S6, S7, S8. Now if it is S1, if input is 0, if input is 0, next state is same S1. Okay, and similarly if input is 1, if input is 1, next state is what? S2, next state is S2. If state 1, if input is 0, output is 0, output is 0. If input is 1, output is 0. Similarly, if it is in S2, if input is 0, then next state is what? S3, and output is 1, output is 1. And if the state is 1, if input is 1, if input is 1, next state is what? S5, next state is what? S5, and output is what? 0, output is 0. So in this way we can create the state table. Now you just see the state, how to reduce the state table. Now these two are same thing. Now we want to remove this one, we want to remove the states. Now you can see here, so already you know when two states are equivalent, one of them can be removed without altering the input output relation. So we look for two present states that go to the same next state and have the same output for both the input. Now you can see here, you can see this one S6 and S7, you can see this one and this one. So S4, if it is 0, input is S6, now S7, S6 to S7, okay, same next state and same output. So we can remove, so S4 and S8, these two are equivalent. Okay, so we can, what we can do, we can remove the state. Now where S8 is there, so if S8 is there, convert this into S4. So here S8 is there, you just cut it and write S4. Any other S8 there? Yeah, another S8 is there, you just write down S4. Okay, any other S8? No S8 is there. Now once again we can check whether any other same states are there or not. Okay, now you can see S4 S2 S4 S2, that means S5 and S6, they are equivalent. That means S5 and S6, they are equivalent. So we can reduce, we can cut this one. Okay, so S5 S6, they are equivalent, so you can cut this one. So if S6 is there, if S6 is there, okay, just write down S5. So any other S6 is there? Yeah, it is S6 is there. So you just put S6 to S5. Okay, any other S6 is there? No. Any other S6 is there? No. Okay, so we can reduce two states. Now we can redraw the thing. Say state S1, S2, S3, S4, S5 and S7. So it is S1, S2, S3, S5, S2, S4, okay? S5, S7, S4, S2, okay? This is S1 and S3. The outputs are 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 1, okay? 0, 1, 1, 0, and 0, 1. And easily we can draw the state diagram, okay? So S1 to S7 are there, S1 state, S1, S2, S3, S4, and S7. Okay, so S1 to S1, if it is 0, 0, if it is 0 and 0, and S1 to S2, if x input is 1, output is 0, if input is 1, output is 0. Similarly, S2 to S3 and S5, S3 and S5, 0 and 1. When it is 0, input is what? 1. When it is 0, output is what? 0. Similarly, from S3 to S2 to S4, S2, that means S2, 0 input, 1 output, S4, 1 input, okay, output is 1. Now, S4 to S5 and S7, S5, 0 input, 0 output, S5 and S7. Where is S7? S7 is there. This is S7. Okay, 1 input and output is 1. Now, S5 to S4 and S2, okay, S5 to S4 and S2, S4, 0 input and 1 output, S4 and S2. Where is S2? S2 is there. 1 input and 0 output. Now S7 is what? S7 to S1, 0 input and 0 output, and S3. Where is S3? This is S3. This is S3. 1 input and 1 output. So S6 should not be there. Okay, so this is what? Simplified state. So you can see here how many total states are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Here, how many states are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 states are there. So here, here total number of states say 8, and here total number of states say 6. So 3 neighborhood, 2 unused states are there, okay? And that means what? For unused states, we use don't care condition. So when you use don't care condition, we obtain clear Boolean function, need less equipment, okay? So if you reduce the number of states, that means to increase the don't care conditions, and using don't care condition, we have now obtained simpler Boolean function. That means we simpler Boolean function means what? We need lesser combinational circuits, we need lesser gates, okay? And that is the use of state reduction, and in this way you can reduce the states, okay? And that is the end of this video. Thank you very much.